Hey, my name is Marcus Hodge, and I'm the band director here at the City of Refuge. Boy, I've been at the City of Refuge, Jesus, since 2007. Yeah, it's been a pretty long time. My band is amazing. They're just simply great guys. We like to fellowship. We like to play together. We gel together. We just got great chemistry. I wouldn't trade these guys for the world. One body, one sound means just coming together as a whole, together collectively doing the same thing. I think it's special to give out awards to the members of the band just so they can be recognized in their gifts, their crafts, what we do, the time that we put in here. We do long rehearsals, we do outside engagements, and those are a few guys that have, do it again. So it's great to honor them. One more time. I believe it's special to give out awards to the band members just because it's a great way to recognize their talents, recognize their gifts, the time that we put in, the rehearsals, like we're here long hours. There's a few people that are dedicated in what we do here. My favorite song that we used to play is called My Mind's Made Up. And you know, we just had a good time playing that. That's one of my favorite records here. I wish we could bring that back. We'll have to talk to Jason McGee. Moments that I like to share that I believe that are really, really great moments that we have as a band is just when we come up to make stuff up on the spot. Like we will learn the song, we will rehearse the song, but if the spirit moves or if anything goes not as planned, we just have a good time as a band and come up with stuff and be able to share and just have fun and gel. And, you know, make moments of it. If I describe my ministry in one word, it would be amazing. Simply amazing. That's two words, but yeah, amazing.
What's up, City of Refuge?
Hey, what's going on, everybody?
Hey, family.
And I want to welcome you to
One Body, One Sound.
Team, both individually and collectively. You're going to see our incredible Lifted Dance Ministry, as well as be under the musical spell of our insanely talented City of Refuge band. But also tonight, we are honoring one member of each entity of the music department with a special award simply to say thank you. Thank you for your service, thank you for your humility, and thank you for your infectious, wonderful spirit to the music department here at the City of Refuge. So, we don't want you to sit back and relax. We want you to get up, dance with us, sing with us, and definitely don't forget to praise God with us. God bless you.
Good evening, city. Good evening, y'all. I'm here to recognize my band. Y'all give them a hand. These guys work hard week after week after week after week, and we just want to thank them for all that they do. But there is a particular guy in our band that we want to recognize on tonight. This guy has been faithful since the time that we hired him. He's been here. He's been just a great team player. And we just want to recognize Brother Brian B-Dub White. Stand up, Brian. Show the people who you are, man. Stand up. Congrats, bro.
Good evening, everyone. Praise the Lord. I am Camille Grigsby, and I am here representing The Bridge, also known as The Worship Team. Amen. Give them a hand. Amen. We want to recognize tonight someone who has really exemplified being a team player this year, really being willing to do whatever is asked and fill in, sometimes singing every week if it requires it. Just a beautiful spirit, has really been a pleasure to work with. We're presenting the Bridge Highest Praise Award this evening to Miss Jennifer Lee. If you would give her a hand. Jennifer, thank you so much for making it a pleasure, for being willing to help out in any way possible. God bless you.
My name is Camille Grigsby. There is a second G, Grigsby. And I am a worship leader with The Bridge. The Bridge is actually the worship and praise team. We call it The Bridge because we believe that praise is the bridge to God. It's one of the ways that we access His presence. Actually, One Body, One Sound to me is a sign of unity. It's everybody being together. Everything that we do sometimes can be real siloed when we get into the, you know, separate choirs, separate entities, but this is actually all of us coming together. I've actually been serving at the City of Refuge since 2003. I believe that is when I probably led my first song here, and then I moved here in 2004, and I've been here ever since. I would say powerful would be the one word, although there are many more, but that's the one word, powerful. I think it's special to give out awards to the members, specifically because there are a lot of people that you don't know about that contribute to what we do. I would say one of my favorites is Everything by Ty Trivett. Something just happens when we start to sing that song. People just, you know, the congregation loves the song, the praise team loves the song, and I think when you start to really talk about what God means to you and who He is to you, you know, it's just something that happens in the atmosphere when we sing that song. That's one of my favorites. Funniest ones, and I don't even know if anybody caught this, but a couple months ago I was leading worship and I put the mic on the stand, so I thought, but I turned around and realized that it wasn't on the stand, and I saw it fall and it hit the ground, and then it rolled, it like made a boom, and then it rolled to the second step, and then it boomed again, and then it rolled to the third step, and I said, okay, I'm gonna have to go down the steps and get it before it gets all the way to the floor. So I had to actually run and go down the steps and pick it up and run back up the steps and say, come on and worship, to try to, you know, make sure. So I don't know if people caught it because it happened really fast, but all I could think of is, okay, if it gets all the way to the floor, then I'm gonna have to run across the floor like Patrick to try to make up for the fact that it got all the way down there. But yeah, then I had to slow down. I said, okay, I was in self for that moment. So I had to really slow down. Next time I'll make sure it gets right on the stand, you know. It was embarrassing, but you know, learn my lesson.
Everybody, I've got something to say. I met this man named Jesus. Oh, the ground is sinking sand. Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, give God a praise in here. Come on, come on, come on, give God a praise. Jesus, Jesus. I'm here to give an award to one of my choir members, and I want to say that the devil did everything they could to try to take this person out. But because this person loved God so much, they was determined to keep giving God some praise, no matter what the man said. When man said no, God said yes. And I want to give this award to this young lady. Sister Lorena, will you come? The doctor told her she couldn't sing for a long time. But she kept on singing and kept on singing, kept on trying to sing. Yeah. When she didn't have a voice, she would still be up here just dancing with us. But God blessed her and healed her body. And now she's able to sing. So we want to bless you with this award. Come on, let's give it to her.
My name is Patrick Bolton. I am the assistant pastor of Worship and Arts. I messed it up. I'm sorry. I'm the second assistant pastor. Got it. My name is Patrick Bolton. I am the second assistant of the minister of music. Lord have mercy. What did you say? Second assistant pastor
of Worship and
Arts. Second assistant pastor of Worship and Arts. Got it. I am Patrick Bolton. I am the second assistant of. Okay, you messed up. Second assistant pastor. Got it. I'm sorry. I got you. My name is Patrick Bolton. I am the second assistant pastor of Worship and Arts, and I'm also the director of Spirit of David and the Men of the City. The Spirit of David is a choir. You know, I'm a church boy. I've been a church boy all of my life. So I love good church songs. I love good choir church songs. And that's what Spirit of David is. They're a churchy choir. We give you a good hand clapping, foot stomping, and we will bless the people with a good church song. You hear me? That's what we will do. The favorite song, what is my favorite song that we do? The Spirit of David, like I said, I love church songs, but I really love All in His Hands. All in His Hands, it gives me a good churchy vibe, gives me a good quartet vibe, because I'm good traditional, all in the same, you know, so I just love giving that little groove, because we got a little two-step that we do to that, praise God. It's called the Baptist Rock. Here. The term one body, one sound means to me is we have five choirs at our church. And it means to me that since we all have different styles, we all sing different type of songs, but we all have the same message. We all have the same mind. We all have the same spirit. So, which means when we all come together, we should just be able to just bless the people together as one. So that's what it means to me, that we're all together with our leader. Whatever our leader tells us to do, we should be able to do it together. Go ahead. I've been at the City of Refuge 21 years, and I came in May of 98, and I've been here ever since. I was never a church hopper. Here? Uh-huh.
Thank you.
Lord, I thank you. I got to move on, but I feel the Holy Ghost in this place right now. The shot. That's how you're supposed to party for Jesus. They down at the club getting their groove on right now. If they can party for the devil, we can party for Jesus. Now I'm really getting ready to make the devil mad now. How many of y'all been through some stuff up in here? Don't y'all fool me. How many of y'all really been through some stuff? Look at somebody, tell us, say, I'm glad I don't look like what I've been through. Come on, come on. We getting ready to bring the new year in right. I don't know if y'all ready. Clap your hands. I hope y'all ready.
Praise him. Jesus. Yeah.
This, all of the nominees on tonight, this was a hard choice because all of the nominees bore the epitome of what this award stands for. We were looking for someone who just had an all-around good spirit, was always positive, always dedicated and consistent. And our three nominees are Evelyn Johnson, Sharon Daniel, and Thelma May. However, Sister Thelma May is unable to be here on tonight because of illness, and we ask that you would keep her in your prayers. But the Ladies of the City Grace Award goes to Sharon Daniels.
My name is Brenda West, and I am the assistant pastor of worship and arts here at the city. Also, I am the director of the Ladies of the City Choir. Also, I am a deaconess here, and I work on the finance committee here, and along with about 17 other jobs that I do here at the city. Ladies of the City, they're a very elegant group. They are a very feisty group because we all have our own personalities. And the majority of us have gotten to a certain age where we say what we want to say and mean it. So that makes it a very, very colorful group. One body, one sound means to me, it means nothing else but unity and bringing everyone together as one body, as the scripture has said that, you know, we are one body. And so that term means exactly that. I think I have been the director of the choir for about 7 years now. And I've been here at the city going on around 10 or 11 years. Elegant. We always strive to, we're called the Ladies of the City. So we try to strive and show how a lady should be. I think it's important to give out awards to the members because everyone needs to feel appreciated. Everybody comes here on their own will, their own time. They put in a lot of time. I think everybody knows it's Pass Me Not. That is my favorite song that the Ladies of the City does. As soon as they hear the music, they're up on their feet. They love that song. A fun moment in the music department. It may not be fun for everybody. I love it when I see Jason and Patrick directing together. I love those moments. I mean, that is just amazing to me.
We Praise the Lord, everybody. Now, normally I wouldn't be saying anything right now. Listen, my name is Jonathan Hunter. I am the minister of dance or director of the dance ministry here called Lifted Dance Ministry. Y'all give it up for the dancers here. How many of you love the Lifted Dance Ministry here? Amen. I love them very much. They work so, so hard. And I'm here to present this year's award. We called it the Leap Award. Everybody say amen for the Leap Award. These young men and young ladies work so hard every Thursday evening from 6:30 until about 9:30 or until I say it's time to go. Sometimes we sweat, sometimes it's a little blood, but that makes a great dancer. And I'm here to present this Leap Award to a wonderful individual. She's shown great strength, courage, and I love her very much. She is so funny. All of them are really funny, but this one, I just want to show this token of gratitude and appreciation to Miss Sanaya Ward. Y'all give it up for my child. We love and appreciate you. Thank you, guys.
My name is Jonathan Hunter. I am the ministry director of Lifted Dance Ministry here at City of Refuge. I'm also a part of every other choir and praise team here in the music ministry as well. So Lifted Dance Ministry, we are here to lift the hearts of the people, the body gestures, the way that we express ourselves on our faces. We're here to sow the love of God within the people's hearts. One body, one sound. It means that we are all on one accord. Anything that we do that is of God, we want to do it as one. And one body, one sound. We are one body and we're making one sound. I have been serving the city for about almost 3 years, I want to say now. Yeah, I think it's 3 years. If I had to describe Lifted in one word, Lifted, period. why Lifted? So it just goes back into explaining what the ministry stands for. Lift it. It's really self-explanatory. We're here to lift the hearts of the broken by way of ministry, by way of introducing them to Christ, by way of showing them what it is to represent Christ in the way that we do. It is important to give out awards to the members just to show appreciation, show them that we are watching, show them that we do see you and that you are just as important as anybody else. Right now, my favorite song that our ministry has done in the past is Victory, originally by Ricky Dillard. And I think tonight's song is going to be my new favorite, but you're going to have to sit in your seat and see what that's going to be about. A fun and memorable moment with Lifted would have to be, honestly, it's each week that I have an opportunity to sit down. We have moments in rehearsals where we're not even dancing, but we're sitting down and we're getting to know each other, we're getting to love on each other, support each other, and to allow God to fill them up so that they can live a successful life beyond just being a dancer.
He leads me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. When you become a believer, your spirit is made right. But sometimes, the soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hole in it due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. Some people's actions are not because their spirit is wrong, but it's because the past has left a hole in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past and remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister Leandria here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Deliver me, 'cause all I seem to do is
Come on, let's give him another hand. Lift it. deliver me. I'm up now to give another award. Y'all pray for me. Jason McGee has sang me all day Sunday, last night, and sang me tonight. I ain't got nothing left. Hit me. Pray the Lord. But I want to give this award to a brother in the men's choir who is such a wonderful man. God has also blessed this brother. It's another brother where man says no, God says yes. He had a situation a few months ago. He had to leave early, and he got sick. And we thought it was going to be very serious, but all I can just say is, but God. But God. Now, that was in 2019. And 2020 is going to be something greater. This young man has been faithful. Every time I turn around, I look for him because he's my motivator in the choir. And I thank him. Every man in the men's choir needs an award because they're all good brothers. But I want to give this award to a man that's been faithful, a man that's did everything I asked him to do. He even got mad at me one time, but he still did what I told him to do. I want to give this to Larry Carter. I don't know, but let me tell you something. God worked a miracle. He had a stroke a few months ago, and we thought it was going to be a big problem. But look at him. God blessed him and healed his body. You can't tell me what God cannot do. Devil is a liar, and he's here to live to tell the story. God bless you.
The men of the city, I love the brothers. They're just gentlemen, and we do some good old four-top style type church music and a Temptations vibe, because we got dance steps. We do all of that stuff, so I love them. If I had to describe my ministry in one word, fire, powerful. Oh, you said one word. I'm sorry. Because I could keep going here. Why do I think it's special to give out awards? Because these people, they come, they're volunteering, first of all. And they come, you know, a lot of these people, they are very dedicated. They're faithful. Anything we ask them to do, they don't complain about it. We ask them to do it, and they do it. So I think it's good to just appreciate them and let them know how much we love them, how much we care for them. For the my favorite song for the men of the city, it's a song called I Don't Look Like What I've Been Through. I'm glad I don't look like what I've been through, because, you know, a lot of us, we've been through a whole lot. All year, it's been crazy, up and down, but you know what? Even though we've been through all of that, I'm glad I don't look like what I've been through. Don't make me jump up, start shouting out here. One moment that's hilarious in the music department. We always just like to have a good time. I love working with Jason. I love working with Brenda. We always laughing, and we're always talking about each other. We always fighting and argue. And my fun moment is this. We argue. I mean, we'd be hollering from the top of our lungs going in. But as soon as we get done, we laughing and saying, I love you, I love you, I love you. So we can call each other names. Ooh, I hate you. I can't stand you. Then when we get done, we're going to eat after we get done, after church. So those are my funny moments. I love it. I love it.
Amen. I want to slow it down some. I'm going to do a little old school now. You know, we danced a little bit, shouted. Yeah, we're going to have a Holy Ghost party. But I want to do a little old school right now. Take it back to a little Sam Cooke day. Yeah. Marvin Gaye day. Y'all don't know nothing about that. Yeah. This is a song that's written by Prez Blackman. He wrote this song. Yeah. And it's such a wonderful song. And I said, you know what? I think I want to do that for New Year's. I want to take it a little old school. So let's receive Brother Prayers Blackman.
You wanna give up, you've had enough. But hold your head up, and know things won't be like this always. Oh, said it won't be like this always. God promised me a better day. So be encouraged, and know things won't be like this always. Made bad decisions, some mistakes too. Been there before. Here's what you should do. Just keep on praying and believe things won't be like.
Bow. Listen, there's an old song that I want to do now, and it says, I can't stop praising his name. I don't know about you, but I'm gonna really take it back because I can't stop praising his name as much as God's been good to me. I don't know about you, but look at somebody and say, you don't know like I know what the Lord has done for me. Come on, let's have a little church now. Come on, just pop your head, cut. Oh.
Sing a song to the Lord. Anybody glad to be praising the name of Jesus? Is anybody glad to be praising the name of Jesus? Can somebody say, I can't stop praising his name? I can't stop giving him glory. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm standing to present the City of Refuge Ensemble Favor Award. And the reason why we're calling it the Favor Award is because the favor that's on the lives of the members, but also because this group was done by them doing me a favor. The ensemble was really not supposed to be a group, but we had a hole to fill, and I reached out to a few of them, and I said, hey, I need some help, y'all. I need some singers to come in and help me out on Fourth Sundays. And these people came, and they have not missed. They show up. They're always ready with their music. And, you know, I try not to rehearse them too hard, but, well, you know me. So it is what it is. But I'm just so grateful. The reality is each one of them deserves this award because of their sacrifice. But my nominees tonight are Mrs. Nikki Bolton, Miss Camille Grigsby, and Mrs. Nicole Stevens. And the winner of the Ensemble Favor Award goes to Mrs. Nicole Stevens. Thank you, Nicole.
So dramatic. This. My name is Jason McGee. I am the pastor of worship and arts here at the City of Refuge, as well as the choir director for the Sanctuary Choir and the ensemble. I mean, I can keep going if you need me to, because I do a lot. The ensemble. The ensemble is actually a newly formed group that wasn't supposed to be a group. It was kind of an accident. And so it was a bit of an interim group. We needed to fill a spot. And these nine incredible, incredible singers willingly answered the call. I was like, yo, just kind of help me out every fourth Sunday. And then it just kind of developed into a beautiful, anointed thing. So the ensemble is, they're my singers. They sing. One body, one sound, to me, is the actual embodiment of unity. It is when so many different things that operate differently, if you will, come together with the same mind, the same intention, and to serve the same God. So we are so many different people in so many different walks of life, and we come together with one mind to serve our one God. And so there's an old saying that says, the whole is greater than the sum of its parts, which means as amazing as you may be individually, you're never gonna be better than you are when you come together. So that's what One Body, One Sound is to me. I've been serving at the City of Refuge since the summer of 2004. That was the first time I ever directed here at the church, which has been about 15 and a half years ago. But I've been going to the church since 1998, when I was six. And my favorite song by the ensemble is My Life, My Love, My All.
Sounds the alarm. gonna be a brighter day. Let me see you dance tonight. Come on.
Saving, so you came and changed my.
Anybody got a yes in your spirit? Does anybody got a yes in your spirit that you've been dying to say all year long? Come on, somebody, just tell God yes. Somebody tell God yes. Hallelujah. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for keeping me. Thank you for waking me up this morning. Thank you for starting me on my way. Somebody just tell God yes. Let that be your answer to the Lord in 2020. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I don't know why in the world I decided to put these things back to back. Well, I don't know about you, but when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, my soul cries out hallelujah. Thank God for saving me. Thank God for keeping me. My answer is yes. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hey!
Anna,
this praise has been brewing in the house all night long. Come on, can somebody give God a yes? Come on! Something happens when the children of God all get together and tell God yes. Something happens when we all become one body and we make one sound, and the sound is yes. Praise God, praise God. Sound like y'all came to praise God tonight on New Year's Eve. Sound like somebody just said, if I could just get to church one more time, if I could just make it to the house of God one more time and give God my yes. Well, if y'all gonna praise him, y'all might as well praise him. If you gonna give him glory, you may as well do it. If you gonna dance, you may as well do it.
praise the Lord, everybody. And everybody praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. I'm so blessed and I'm so honored to also be the choir director of the Sanctuary Choir here at the church. The Sanctuary Choir, they have a ridiculously special place in my heart. I've been with the Sanctuary Choir. I think they were the first choir I've ever directed here, right here at the city, from 2004 until now. So you know, these my folk. They're the only ones that throw me a party, y'all. They love a brother. So the Sanctuary Choir Harmony Award is presented to one of the members who always keeps harmony, both spiritually and naturally, in their section. Our nominees for that are, from the soprano section, it's Sister Angie Hunter. From the tenor section, Sister Cynthia Johnson. And from the alto section, Sister Hattie Tatum. Come on over, y'all. And our winner of the Sanctuary Choir Harmony Award is our own Sister Hattie Tatum.
Yeah, go that way, go that way. I direct the Sanctuary Choir. The Sanctuary Choir is what I call the home base choir. The Sanctuary Choir is kind of, we've done all the recordings for the church, and we're kind of like, we're the foundation, if you will, of the music department. So it's the choir that's been the longest standing. I would like to say they're the most consistent, if I may. They're the church's, choir, if you will. The word I would use to describe the ministry at the City of Refuge, unpredictable, very unpredictable around here. You know, you'll show up with one thing and all of a sudden you get 64 different things thrown at you and you have to kind of like duck and dodge and shake and move. But at the same time, you'll plan a song and it may not even go well in rehearsal, but then all of a sudden you get here and you literally see the chains breaking and you see the walls coming down and you're like, we didn't even know this was coming. And so the City of Refuge, the music department as well, just highly unpredictable. You just never know what's coming. Oh, my favorite song by the Sanctuary Choir, and as exhausted as it makes me, as much as my shoulders hurt after I directed, is still The Blood Still Works. Something happens to me when we get to that, I know that the blood still works. Something happens to me in that moment and I lose myself. I guess, I don't know if I go into the spirit at that moment, maybe I've been in flesh every other time, but I go into the spirit at that moment. I think the funniest moment for me happened recently. It was between myself, Patrick, and Brenda. Patrick and I had to take a minute and go in the back and scream at each other and then only to walk back out and be like, praise the Lord, everybody. And literally seconds later, he was like, you get on my nerves, you get on mine too, now give me a hug. Typically the moments between me, Patrick, and Brenda, when we're sitting on the side and we don't know what's gonna happen next, but the three of us, we just kind of piggyback off each other like, all right, let's figure this out.
Christ, he is a new creature. Behold, all things have become new.
Morning Sanctuary Choir. Praise the Lord. Did you enjoy yourselves tonight? So, I've been the minister of music here for almost 2 years, and this is the first event that I've personally directed and or oversaw. And I must say, they did a great job, right, y'all? You know, it was easier to talk, direct, than talk when I first started here. Well, I was 24. It ain't the same. Things are very different now. Things are older and heavier now, amen? Take a lot to get all this body off the ground. You hear me? You try. Praise God. I'm gonna just thank a few people, and then we're gonna close out for our portion. But first, y'all, my very, very, very first choir director is here, everybody, and it's my mom. Mom, can you stand up? Yes, she is that short. Hey, Mom. Hey, boo. Good to see you, sugar. Everyone always says, who did you study growing up? I said, I actually lived with the person I studied. So thank you, Mom. Appreciate you. Love you. Really quickly, before I give the last award, I want to thank a few people, and I'll make it really fast. None of this, a leader can only have a vision, but it takes the people to carry it out. And I want to thank the City of Refuge Church for always saying yes to my vision. To Bishop Noel Jones, to Edwin, to all the deacons. I don't know that I've ever been here and heard the word no for the things that I've asked for. I've heard the words, you have to raise the money yourself, but I didn't hear no. But I'm so grateful that when I go to Bishop and when I go to Edwin and when I go to the staff here, everyone always says, all right, Jay, just let us know what you want to do. Let us know how it's going to work, and we'll make it happen for you all. Even the security guards staying a little later and just all the things that go into making this work. Thank you, everybody. It doesn't go unnoticed. It does not go unnoticed, and we thank you so much to the audio and the visual team here at the City of Refuge. Shelby King, Anthony Branch, Daryl Ray, Sharon Will, and everybody else that works on the team, thank you so much. Y'all, Shelby grabbed the vision that I gave him and literally just turned it into what you see before you. Thank you, Shelby. I appreciate you, man. You'll never know how much. Thank you so much. To Brother James Poole, Brother Prince James, Brenda for overseeing it. All the stage decor that you see was done by these three people. All right, y'all, thank you so much. To my lighting guy, Mr. Juan Cuevas, thank you so much, sir. Appreciate you, man. Thank you. Juan is the best. We worked together many years ago, and when he came back, he still gives me a hard time this many years later, but I love you, and I wouldn't trade you for the world. Well, maybe the world, but I wouldn't trade you for a couple dollars. Love you, bro. Thank you so much. Thank you. To my new stage manager who came home from college and jumped in at the last minute, Miss Amani Moffitt. Where's Amani? There you are, cutie. Thank you so much. To all the stagehands, Nicole, Natalie, Nikki, Prince James, Brianna, Jennifer. Did I forget anybody? Did I get everybody? I did it? Shoo, I guess it ain't that old. Thank you so much. Thank y'all, appreciate y'all. Before I thank my officers, Camille, where my phone? Oh, thank you. Y'all, that's Camille. She's the best. Oh, I was there. To my officers, to my newest officer, and one of the most hardworking people that literally is in the music department right now, the new leader of our dance ministry, Lifted, Mr. Jonathan Hunter. To my big sister, nobody can argue like we can, but nobody can make magic on stage together like we can. My big sis, the leader of the worship team, Miss Camille Grigsby. To one of my favorite people in life, one of my biggest annoyances in life,
and probably the only person I would ever call to MD anything for me in life, Mr. Marcus Hodge, y'all. Ooh, Marcus, get on my nerves, but I love you, man. To my second assistant pastor of worship and one of the hardworking brothers here at the church, and like I said last night, I'm glad this stage is too high because he can't run around, Mr. Patrick Bolton. And let me tell y'all something. Let me tell y'all something. The Lord blessed me this year to direct a tour in Japan for a little over a month. And one of the singers is here. Hey, Ray. And the keyboardist, hey, Trey. Good to see y'all. And I was gone for literally in the middle of the planning of this. I was gone. But there was a young lady who was my first assistant pastor of worship who literally grabbed the music department by the horns and didn't let anything fall. She has been my entire right hand and my right arm and maybe even a left arm on this one. Literally, we call each other all hours of the night like, yo, Brenda, I got to work this thing out. Like, I don't know how we're going to do this. And she makes it happen somehow. And we literally have each other's back left, right, and forward. Y'all give it up for Mrs. Brenda West. When I tell you none of this would be possible without Brenda, thank you. I love you. Thank you very much, very much. Can y'all give it up for my officers, y'all? And while you're at it, give it up for the world's greatest music department. When I tell you, I start crying yesterday in rehearsal because let me tell you, these young people and seasoned people came out here and hung out with a brother for over 3 days, and literally no one, like I told them, I didn't hear anybody complaining. They might have did it, but I didn't hear it, and I appreciate it. And I thank them so much for their love and their support. It's nothing for them to grab me in the back and pray with me. It's nothing for them to grab me in the back and hug me and say, yo, you're doing a really good job. It's a beautiful thing when people that are twice your age say, I respect you. That's a beautiful thing. That's a beautiful thing. And I love you all so much. Thank you, music department. I really appreciate you. Thank you. Thank you so much. And the final award of the night is given by the Minister of Music. It is an award that it is a person that I selected personally without nominees. And fortunately, there were at least 20 people that would really qualify for this award because that's how great these people standing behind me are. They're incredible people to work with. They're anointed and they're wonderful. But there was one person that really stood out in my mind immediately, but it took me about a week to really decide, but that person just kept ringing in my spirit. It's someone that works extremely hard in our music department, is very diligent, is always here, is ridiculously faithful, literally will take nothing and turn it into something, has the heart of the music department in their heart, literally grabs everything by the horns and said, I'll do it, whatever you need, I'll do it, came up with a plan of attack for this year of something that they wanted to see and literally has made it happen 3 times over. So would you please help me give this the Champions Award. It's the Music Ministry Champion Award. So the one, the only, Mr. Jonathan Hunter. When Jonathan came to me and said, I want to resurrect the dance ministry, I said, what do you want to do? He came up with a whole syllabus and a whole plan and 65 emails about what he wanted to do and how he wanted to form it. He has literally taken this dance ministry from nothing into the amazingly anointed dance ministry that you see. Him and Brother Antonio Tate, Antonio, like this. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. When I was in Japan, I called Jonathan almost every day screaming at him about these t-shirts. Lord have mercy, these t-shirts. But I called him. I said, Jay, get on it. I need you to get on it. And I rode his coattail so hard. And he literally responded with a, thank you for always staying on me. Thank you for encouraging me. That's a leader, y'all. That's a leader. A leader has to learn how to follow first. Jonathan, thank you, man. I love you. It doesn't go unnoticed. Y'all mind if we do our last song? Come on, Patrick. What voice you got left? All year long, I've been doing church songs, so come on, put your hands together. We're getting ready to get on out of here. Come on, clap your hands, everybody. Mm-hmm. clap your hands. You may have your seats in the presence of the Lord. We are about 45 minutes into 2020. Amen. Let's give God a hand praise. Listen, just before our bishop come out,
I just want to remind everybody this coming Sunday will be our launch of January 31st, 2020 at 7:30 p.m. We will be celebrating our bishop for his 70th birthday. Amen. The party will be probably 10 times greater than what you saw tonight. Amen. Tickets will be on sale this coming Sunday. Tickets for general admission is $70. VIP is $250. If you want to just hurry up and get your ticket, you can get it online today at cityofrefugela.org. Put your hands together for the best pastor on this side of heaven. Amen. Come on, you can do better than that. He preached to us 52 weeks. Amen. Put your hands together to receive our pastor, Bishop Jones, that he's coming his own way.
Take somebody's hand, if you will. And certainly we give God praise, and we are very grateful to God because he's brought us through another year. And with all of the difficulties that we've had, if you're standing and clothed and in your right mind, you had to have some victories. Sometimes we have a proclivity to give more thought to the things that we failed than the things that we had victories over. But if you've made it to this point, then you can give God the glory because he brought you out with a mighty hand. Squeeze those hands so slightly. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you and we thank you. We are very grateful. Because when many have fallen on the way, you have kept us standing in the middle of all of the difficulties that we have faced. And you're saying to us, as we face another year, that the things that we have expected and hoped for, that you will bring them to pass. You know the idiosyncratic need of my brother and my sister. You know what is going on through the minds of the hands that I hold. You know the regrets. You know the sorrows. You know the confessions. But we also thank you because of the exposure that you have given us to the light, and that you have manifested yourself to us in many ways this year that we never thought we would see you in. So now, Lord, we pray that this becomes just the seed for what's going to happen for the rest of our lives, and that this day will be the beginning of the rest of our lives. And we claim the power that you have given us. We claim the wisdom that we have received. We claim what we have overcome. And we plant it as a seed tonight, that it will be a harvest in the years to come. And we claim the victory right now in the name of Jesus. So I squeeze power in these hands. I squeeze a fresh anointing in these hands. I squeeze deliverance in these hands. Financial prosperity in these hands. I squeeze sagacity in these hands. Healing in these hands. Victory in these hands. And I claim the victory right now in the name of Jesus. And we'll give you the glory and the praise. I praise you for every victory that's about to take place. I praise you for every seed that's going to become a harvest. I praise you for every tomorrow that begins with today. I praise you for every power that I'm going to receive. And I claim it done right now. And if you believe God, give God the glory. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I wish you would just walk from your seat and give three people a hug and tell them God's got a blessing with your name on it. God's got a blessing with your name on it. Woo!
my mind is made. I'm on my way. Gonna hold my, going on with the Lord.
Give God great praise for. We don't always look at the significance of music in reference to worship. But if you check your Bibles closely, you will find in 2 Kings, I think it's about chapter 3 and about 15, when the prophet, he did not want to prophesy. Whatever's happening with this, it's going to happen, you know. And he said, send for the minstrel. And the minstrel came and euphoniously and melodiously played the music that God brought the anointing in. If you remember David with Saul, and when Saul was possessed by demonic powers, that David would play. And when he would play, what you notice was that the demons had to back up a little bit until Saul became possessed. Once Saul became possessed, then it was a different point. But we never ever give any credence, any credulity, any real thought to the significance of music in the church. But one of the great things that we can say in the City of Refuge is that God has blessed us with a music department, and do you all believe it? They are, my music department is regarded around the world, and I'm not just saying in America, but around the world as the most prolific and the most anointed that exists. And I thank God for the music department and their leadership. Amen. Come on, put your hands together. This is your music department. And we thank God for all of them, Jason and Patrick and Dr. West, and just, it's just marvelous and wonderful. Now, on my way to church, I called a comedian because I wanted a comedian to help us to laugh into next year. Some of us need a good laugh. But all the comedians were somewhere working. But maybe there's just one in this place who didn't have a job. Come on, sweetheart.
and give me about 5 minutes. How you? Absolutely. Bring me a mic, please. Here's a microphone. All right. You got to tell them who you are. I know who you are, but they don't.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. This is such amazing. I'm like, wow. Okay. My name is Caramel Gray. I'm originally from Florence, Alabama. Roll Tide. Don't play with me. I know we lost. I'm still going through right now. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so listen. I'm single, but I ain't crazy. What is going on with you LA people, LA men out here? Y'all don't ask nobody out for no coffee, no tea. Don't I look like I like to eat? What's wrong with y'all? But I tell you what, God got a sense of humor, because when I moved out here, I met this guy, I thought he was gonna be the one. I wind up homeless out here. Now that ain't funny. Y'all need Jesus. 3 years I was homeless out of the five I've been out here. And while I was homeless, I didn't understand that bed bugs is real. I wish somebody would have said, don't let the bed bug bite. I sweat for peanut butter, I'll pop you in the head. It don't make no sense. But see, the reason why God wanted me to go through that is because I have a heart for the homeless. I can't walk past and drive past homeless people and without helping. You're going to be entertaining an angel one day. You better start listening to your spirit. I tell you, the three years of being homeless, he was whooping me. He was stripping me away. He took my car, took my job. He took me so low, only place I could look was up. And he was right there. But in the midst of it, if you can see, I got my own little style. I don't like dressing like nobody. I don't like being like nobody. I'm comfortable in my own skin. And sometimes you go around women that's not so comfortable, they don't like your way you move. But you ain't gonna change me, baby. The devil is a lie. I like me. You hear what I said? I said, I like me. And I had this blue jean jacket, and some people may have seen me wear it last Sunday. It had two arms. But this girl that I had a roommate with, she had the nerve to put a hole in it. I said, girl, you don't know who you messing with. I cut that whole arm off and still be wearing it to church. I'm going to turn some lemons into some lemonade. You hear what I said? Don't play with me. And then, look. God got a sense of humor because he moved me into the jungles. I said the jungles. Ooh, You know that old song, the freaks come out at night? Baby, they all up in the jungles. Every day I be like, Lord Jesus, why you got me here? He say, I got you here because I need you to shine your light over here. So I don't take it lightly. Wherever he put me, I'm going to shine my good doggone glory, his glory that's in me. But one day, these girls live next door to me. I hope y'all watching. Is that my cue to get off the stage? I'm about to talk about somebody. I don't understand how you don't, can't. My time is up. Okay, that's my time. Thank you, Bishop. Oh, my God. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's offering time, and the next decade is coming, and so tonight I said to myself, I want to sow a seed of $1,000, because I believe next year is a year of manifestation. So I want to sow a seed. I need 50 people to get a $100 gift in their hand. Now, it's not hocus pocus. I'm not saying the Lord told me to ask. I'm simply saying that with all of us here, I believe there are 50 people who can get $100 in their hand and join me tonight. $100 that you didn't spend on champagne. Yes, that you didn't spend in the club tonight. You came to the house of God, and I want you to sow a seed. So everybody who'll join me with a $100 gift, I want you to stand. Stand with me. God bless you, sir. I saw you early. I saw you. God bless you. Amen. Sister Valle, and she's representing her husband. $100 gift. Stand, Loretta. Stand. Those who will join me tonight. I'm looking for 50 people to join me tonight. Not with 1,000, but with 1/10. My father told me that you have to set the example if you're raising an offering, if you're asking God to give. Then you have to set the example. And I've done it through the years. And God has blessed me in ways that I never expected. Everybody that'll give, you can sit now. Thank you very much. Thank you. I want you to raise your offering to heaven. Get the best gift you have. And sow the seed, believing God for next year. And those who have sowed into this ministry over the years, we honor you, we thank God for you, and we bless God for the giving that you have done. And I will be in your country sometime this year, and we believe God for a great miracle and great blessing when that happens. Raise your offerings to heaven. This is the last gift you're giving to God this year, the last tithe, the last. And if you have nothing, I would recommend that you raise your hands to God, and you're raising it by faith that this year I will be a blessing to the house of God. There are many things that God's going to do in this house. We're going to expand this place from the village of refuge to the city of refuge to the metropolitan of refuge, to the cosmopolitan, to whatever. Father, we thank you now for every giver, every gift, and we just I'm so grateful because you have helped us to feed the poor. You have helped us to give housing. You've helped us to make ways. You've helped us to make loans, to bless people. You've helped us to do all kinds of things. And we say thank you because you have been gracious to us. And in all of our giving, we didn't lose our cars. We didn't lose our houses. We didn't lose anything. You have kept us while we gave to others. And we want to say thank you. Now bless us as we expand, not only from our communities, but throughout the world, where water is needed, where health is needed, where many, many things are needed. Give us that global footprint, and we claim it right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Be slave.
Put your hands together. You're here to have a good time tonight. If you know it's gonna be all right, can I get some help out here tonight? Let's go. Hey.
Brother Maynard just gave us 1,000. And Brother Dennis Washington, 3,000.
Thank you for these tithes and these offerings, God. We pray that you multiply it for the use of your kingdom so that souls can be saved, delivered, and set free in Jesus' name. Señor, te damos gracias por estas ofrendas. Bendice a tu pueblo en abundancia en el nombre de Cristo Jesús. Amen.
Corinthians chapter 2, and for a few minutes in verse 9, but as it is written, eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. But God hath revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the things of God save the Spirit of God which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man but the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God. I want you to look at somebody with all the ebullience you can find, all the last energy you have for the year 2019, and tell them the year of manifestation is coming. One writer says that the, and I quote, the pessimist sees a difficulty in every opportunity, but the optimist sees an opportunity in every difficulty, unquote. The bounty of God becomes as an exhaustless opportunity to anyone who has faith. It becomes an exhaustless opportunity for anyone with spiritual inclination. If you can operate outside of your sensual perception, which connects you to your world, and operate within the parameters of faith, which connects you to God, then what seems to be a difficulty to the average person becomes an opportunity to the person who is operating in faith and believing God. It is interesting because as we walk through this earth and as we live for the time that God has allowed us on the earth, our greatest battle is between our sensual perception and our faith in God. What is it that I see through my senses as opposed to what I believe God for through faith? And the interesting thing is that every child of God has an intensive battle because we're always warring between our sensual perception, which connects us to our world, and the faith in God, which brings revelatory experiences to those who trust him and understand that he does not have to operate within the situation in order to give us the revelation that everything in our lives is going to work out just fine. I was reading Spurgeon earlier today, and Spurgeon says, and I quote, "To think that our little cups could exhaust the ocean of his grace." And he added to that, "that I have not seen nor ear heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him, but God hath revealed them unto him by his Spirit." I need you to touch somebody real quick and say, "I have his Spirit." So Christian optimism then is born out of viewing God's bounty not from the natural or the carnal or the temporal or the situation, but viewing the bounty of God from the power of the Spirit through the Word of God, which brings us from anything negative to everything positive. Because in our spirits, we realize that God has already brought to pass those things that we have expected of him and hoped of him. When I think of that, I think of Moulton and Mulligan. And Moulton and Mulligan, they deal with faith in a different manner. What they regard faith is, as is the title deed of things that are hoped for, And the faith becomes the title for the things that you expect from God and that you're looking for God to deliver in your spirit. There is nobody in here that can declare that they have faith if they have no expectation for what God is going to do tomorrow. Because faith is the hypostasis of things hoped for. It is the elikos of things not seen. I can hope for what I don't see, because if you see it, it's not hope. And if you see it, then you don't have to hope for it because you have it right before you. But everything that has happened in my life, I expected it before it came to pass, which means I had to have a hope that is an integral part of faith. That declared, because I expect it, I have the title deed. Now, I need to go further with that. I have bought many properties around the world, and some properties, one I bought last year in the Philippines that I haven't even seen yet. And somebody says to me, well, how do you know you have it? And my answer is simple. I have a description on a title deed, and the title deed has my name on it, which means that I have it even if I haven't seen it. You see, faith then becomes a title deed for things that you have not seen yet. But I expect it because my faith gives me the title to the things that God has promised me. I could say in an instant then that I am entitled. You know, some people operate in a way that that they are entitled, and they have an attitude, if you notice, that some people pull into a parking space even though you've been waiting for a little while, and they pull into a parking space and don't expect you to say a word. Some people operate even in your space as if they're entitled to the things that you have, because they walk in with an attitude as if you cannot deny me even what belongs to you, because I live in the space of being entitled. Well, the child of God who expects God to deliver what he promised lives in a place of entitlement, because I am a child of God and I believe God. And when I believe God, Satan cannot stop him from operating in my life. Everything I've been through in this year has set me up for the entitlement of what I am to receive next year. I don't have the time to deal with the theological ramifications or the exegetical presentation, but I have the time to inspire. And my inspiration to you is that you cannot live this life without expectation that the God who made you promises is going to bring them to pass. And when you have expectation, you live in praise in spite of your situation, because I don't glorify God by situation. I give him praise because of revelation that in spite of what I am going through, everything is going to be all right. I would not be a child of God if I would think that next year is going to be more ominous than this year. I am believing God that everything I went through this year is going to prepare me for the benefits of next year. And somebody says, well, how do you know? Well, eye hath not seen, neither has ear heard. Nobody told me what God's gonna do for me next year. And I have not seen what God's going to do for me next year. But I have something that goes beyond sight and goes beyond hearing. I have the Spirit of God. And the Spirit of God gives revelatory experiences that the eye has not seen. I wish I were talking to somebody who understood. There is something in your spirit that in spite of what you have gone through, your spirit says the victory victory shall be yours. There is something in your spirit, in spite of how Satan has manipulated your situation, that says, in spite of your manipulation, in spite of your condemnation, something in my spirit has come alive, and God has shown me in my spirit. Give me a minute, Pat. Come on, hit it real quick. God has shown me in my spirit that no weapon that has formed against you this year shall prosper. It's going to go bankrupt. Give somebody a high five and say, neighbor, everything the devil planned is going bankrupt. It looks like he's prospering. It looks like he's got me in a corner. But I've been in a corner before, and God brought me out with a mighty hand. I've been down before, but God raised me up. I've been knocked down, but I haven't been knocked out, because something about the Holy Spirit that'll allow you to go so low that he'll bring you up again. I've come to declare that 2020 is the year of manifestation, that you're going to see what God has promised you in your spirit. Give somebody a high five and say, neighbor, it's been in my spirit, and I'm going to give birth to it in 2020. Everything God impregnated me with is coming out in 2020. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare the power of your Holy Ghost, that you're going to open up in our spirits everything that you promised. And as we go into the new year, we go in praising and lifting up your name. I declare it right now. Lay hands on somebody and tell them it's done. Everything you expected, everything you believe, everything you hope God to do, everything you expected from the Lord, it's already done. Declare the year of manifestation. Touch three people real quick and say, Happy New Year. Happy New Decade. Happy New. Somebody a hug. You ain't gonna catch nothing. Give somebody a hug. Say Happy New Year. I made it. What do you know about Jesus?
All right. He's all right. He's all right. Another year. He got your holy request.
Amen. We want to thank God for B Slay. Come on, put your hands together. Give God a hand. Pray for B Slay. Listen, this concludes our New Year's Eve service. There will be no Bible class today. It's New Year's Day. We will be back in our regular service at 8 a.m., 11 a.m., and 6 p.m. this coming Sunday. Amen. No texting and driving. Please get home safe. Amen. Happy New Year. Amen. If you need prayer, if you want somebody to pray with you, just come to the altar. We have our ministry here. Amen. Amen. Just hold tight. Okay. Amen. If you just need somebody to help, if you want prayer, we are here. We would never end a service without giving you the opportunity to give your life to the Lord. Amen. But it is a wonderful day. Amen. We made it. Amen. 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 I'm doing it right now, ma'am. I'm doing it right now. I'm making an altar call. Amen. Amen. We are here to receive you. Come on. Hello? Hello? I have somebody waiting. If I have any preachers down front that's ready to pray with somebody, if you can hurry up and come back, we have a soul. Amen. Amen. Come on. I know we celebrating, but yes, yes, come on. Anyone else want to give their life to the Lord? Come on. Amen. Amen. We are here. Father God, in the name of Jesus, bless us as we go. Go with us. Go before us. Get us home safely. In Jesus' name we pray. Can somebody say amen? Amen. God bless you.